This is where many frogs and toads meet every breeding season, pond number 2. And it's where Dr. Michael Forstner and his students do most of their research on the endangered Houston toad, now on the edge of extinction.
So the Houston toad used to occur from Houston to where we are now in Bastrop. They're gone from Harris, Fort Bend, and Liberty. And in the last 50 years, we've lost almost all of that habitat.
And as the loss of habitat continues, estimates are that there are less than 2,000 Houston toads left.
Look, there he is right there.
I got him. I got him. I got him. And there's that speckled belly and that dark black throat.
With no females to mate with, the outlook for Houston toads here at pond number 2 isn't good.
So it's the unicorn in the woods. I mean, this is the thing that no one can find. And yet, at the same time, this is an animal that makes 3,000 eggs at a time. 3,000.
To capitalize on all those eggs, the Houston Zoo has started a nursery of sorts.
Yeah, here's a female.
We're starting to form a captive assurance colony, basically, and that is a like a fail-safe against the extinction of the Houston toad in the wild.
The zoo took eggs from that same pond number 2 and spent over a year raising 3,000 tadpoles, feeding them 6,000 crickets a week. Then it's back to pond number 2 in Bastrop.
63.4. This is an investment of 3 years of effort, 2 years of planning, and a year of implementation. All right, we're ready. We're going right around the corner. Babies don't do well in the wild. Adults have a better chance of survival, and there's a better chance that they could reproduce this year. Don't run from him.
This is the last chance to try and get Houston toads to mate this year. And soon after the toads are released, the calls commence.
Hear it?
Yes.
It's at least 3 males.
What do you hear?
Our guy's calling. You can hear our head-started males calling. That's fantastic.
This is the whole point. That hold that he has on her is called amplexus and is the mating posture for the Houston toad. And that event all by itself is rare enough to have made coming out tonight worth all of the effort.
This final act may be a success, but it's also a sign of how close we are to losing the Houston toad forever.
Having to release Houston toads that we've head started is both good and bad in my mind. It is very good because we're actively participating in recovery. But it's bad because in some ways it means that it's gotten remarkably serious in the wild within its last holdout, within the last place that Houston toads are doing well. Even here, we're having to intervene.
For Texas Parks and Wildlife, this is Lydia Saldana.